If all this time you think that losing weight can only be done on a treadmill or by lifting weight, now I'm gonna share you how to lose weight while you sleep. Hi everyone, welcome to our favorite channel, Triple H, How to Be Happy and Healthy. And I am Dr. Hans. As a nutritionist, I'm working on a functional medicine. Now I'm gonna share you how to lose weight while you sleep. Okay, maybe some of you think about losing weight is just about how to do some e-words that you usually heard so far, such as diet, exercise, and supplementation. How many of you think that if you want to lose weight, we have to do a strict diet, the diet a paleo diet, mayo diet, Mediterranean diet, then carnivore diet, keto diet, and etc. And all of those have the same purpose to lose weight. Then the second thing that people always think is about exercise. What kind of exercise that can burn as many calories as you can do? For what? To lose weight. Yeah, that's many people have that common thing about losing weight. It's all about exercise, diet. And the last thing is about supplementation. Yes, supplementation. That's why many people trying to selling slimming pills, slimming tea, or any kind of slimming treatment that related to supplementation. And all of those actually related lead to healthy metabolism. So if you have a healthy metabolism, let's say that let's imagine if you have fit vehicle, like a car or maybe a motorcycle or anything. If you want to go somewhere, it's really easy for you to get to your target. But if you have a broken vehicle, a broken car, broken motorcycle, broken boat or anything, even you have to have a short distance, it's pretty hard for you, right, to get to the target. So it's just the same metabolism. It's our metabolism. If you want to lose weight, or maybe in some people you want to gain weight, gain muscle, you have to have good metabolism. And many people think that metabolism is only about eating and body weight. It's not as simple as that, unfortunately. So what is the real context of metabolism? Metabolism is how willing is the body to spend energy. Yeah, either your body think that you have a lack of storage, or maybe your body have abundance of energy. So it's about the long-term process. It's not just about eating and you don't gain weight, oh then you have a good metabolism. Not as simple as that. Okay, so many people still think about the context, the correlation about metabolism and a burn calories. That what I said before, it's always a talk about diet and exercise, diet and exercise. Well, I'm not saying that a diet and exercise is not related, it's not important to your metabolism, but it's more than that. It's more than that. So what I said before, metabolism is how your body willing to spend or to storage energy. So that's why what I'm saying about why the calorie concept is not work by itself. If you think about a calorie concept, calories in, calories out, if you eat many calories then you spend less, you will gain weight. Not as simple as that. I'm not saying that calorie is not work at all, but you have to know about the basic concept of calorie, of metabolism. Why doesn't the calorie concept work? The first thing, the reason, is about it's really hard to count calories accurately. If you follow about the update about this study, there are many studies that shows that if you eat a raw celery, maybe it will contain about 6 to 7 calories each stick. But if you stew it without adding any spice, any seasoning, any ingredients, it will up the calories about 30. Yeah, so it will multiply about 5x. So what does it mean? It means that like to count calories itself, it's pretty hard. It's pretty hard, even for expert like me. Counting calories is just about like how you estimate, how you just like put it in average. And the most important thing, if you count calories in a raw, like you eat like a raw vegetables and you cook it, it will be different. So yeah, you know, you do the math. Yeah, then it's the second thing, it's not a long-term strategy to maintain weight loss or fat loss. Yeah, if you want to do like a weight loss or even more about fat loss, it's not a long-term strategy. Why it happened? Because your body doesn't like to be in a starvation mode. Your body doesn't like when you reduce your weight, because your body have that set point that like trying to maintain your weight like a how they like a most often time. Then if you lose weight too fast, let's say like you lose like 10 pounds in a week, you will have rebound effect by what? By increase your hunger, by increase your like a leptin hormone. So it will make you like a craving and you want to eat more and eat more and eat more. So if you lose like 10 pounds in a week, maybe you will gain like more in the next week. Then the third thing, it's only represent the number but not the quality. So like what I said before, I'm not saying that calories is not work at all, but it only represent the quantity. 200 calories of broccoli, it's totally different with 200 calories of donut or maybe like a peanut butter sandwich. I think like it doesn't need the rocket science to learn about it. Right, maybe your grandma is right about like when she told you about like don't eat that chips, don't eat that like a cookie because it make you fat. And yes, it's right, she's right. So maybe you think that you are smarter than your grandma or than your mom, that you know that the calorie concept, but it's not work as dumb as that, if I may say about it. The calorie concept, it's just like represent about the quantity, but it doesn't represent about the quality of the food. And your body doesn't have that calorie receptor. I think you guys know about it. Your body has the hormonal receptor, the neurotransmitter receptor. So it doesn't have the calorie receptor that you ever think about it so far. And number four, it's not applicable for people who often eat outside. I think it's like related to the number two that I mentioned before. So like if you eat outside, you will never know like how much the weight that they put on the scale, on the stove, on the pan. You just know about like how it is when it's done, when it's designed like a plate happen on your plate. So I think it's pretty like ridiculous when you just measure the cooked food, because like the weight, it depends on like how you cook it, the method, the process, right? Then number five, we create the change, but we think, we expect that all other factors remain the same. It's related to the like if you ever heard about like the thermogenic adaptation. Yeah, or adaptive thermogenics. So it's like the context when you lose weight, your body will reduce the expand as well. You couldn't just like reduce your intake and you still expect that your body just all things remain the same. Because when you reduce your intake, it's just like you reduce your source, your fuel, your body resource, then your body still like have the same expense. You will die in just like maybe in a week or 2 weeks, because your body will like a lack of energy. So your body will like trying to adapt with what you eat, with the reduction that you made. So what is the biggest part of metabolism? And the biggest thing is about BMR. The second thing is about like NEAT, non-exercise activity, then EAT, exercise activity, then the last thing is TEF, thermal effect of food. But the biggest among all of this is about BMR. So it's about like approximately about 70% of TDEE is like in a BMR. So what is BMR? BMR is like a basal metabolic rate. So basal metabolic rate is the simple thing. It's about like how your body works even you don't do anything. Like what? Sleep. Yes. So if you think so far that sleep is just like your body do nothing when you sleep. No. Your body still work like it is. You know, your brain still works, then your lungs still breathing, then your heart still throbbing, then your stomach, your intestine still working, making that peristaltic movement and stuff. You know, that our body is not shut down while we sleep. And how we improve our sleep is like the most important to lose weight, to make like a fat loss as well. So, how our metabolism actually works? The first thing we have to understand about like the homeostasis, the long-term homeostasis, your adaptive metabolic. Then the second thing we have to know about how our body willingness to spend in a long term. So it's not just like while we're talking about like healthy lifestyle, it's not just about like a 2 months program or maybe 3 months program, like what people oftenly ask to me, like how long will I do it? Dude, it's for your lifestyle. It's for your long-term process, not just for like a program 2 or 3 months, right? So why? Because you have to maintain, you have to like adjust your set point. So how you adjust your set point is talking about not talking about calorie, not talking about like making like a calorie deficit. So, but I'm talking about like a hormonal balance. So there are many hormonal that involve in your metabolism. It's not just like maybe 1 or 2 or 3 hormones, but all hormones is like involving in your metabolism. But I want to talk more about like insulin, cortisol, HGH, thyroid, yeah, and etc. But I think the 4 of this is like more important when we talk about like metabolism, when we talk about like body weight or maybe like fat loss. So how to boost your metabolism while you sleep? The first thing, yeah, improve your sleep quality. Sleep is not about just duration, 7 to 8 hours. Yes, it's good, but it's not just about the hours, the duration, but you have to catch up with the quality as well. So how to do it? Why? Because if you lack of sleep, you will increase your stress. And if you increase your stress, you will increase your cortisol. If you increase your cortisol, it will make you craving. It will trigger the hormone like a leptin that I said before. Aside that, the high cortisol will increase your blood sugar as well. So it will ask you to get more glucose. It will spike your insulin and the endings. It will make you like a hard to lose weight. The second thing, you should like optimize your thyroid. We all know about thyroid. Thyroid gland is like a very important, but it's not about thyroid gland. It's about like your pituitary gland as well, because it's also related. The TSH, the T3, the T4, it's all related with the thyroid level of your body. So how to optimize your thyroid? Like I'm not talking about like a hypo or hyper in this video. Maybe we will talk about it later, because it will be like a long explanation talking about like hypothyroid, hyperthyroid. But in general, how to optimize your thyroid? You can use like some nutrition like zinc, selenium, iodine. I think these three nutrients, it's really important to maintain and to keep up with your thyroid. The third tips is like about have a colder sleep. There are many studies that shows that like if you sleep in a colder temperature, it will like make your body like produce more heat, to make your body produce more brown fat, which is this is like a good fat to burn your bad fat, which is like a bigger or white fat. The fourth thing is about like having cold showers. You can have like before you sleep, right before you sleep, or maybe in the evening, just like pick your time, because the cold shower can increase your eustress. So not all stress are bad. There is some stress that beneficial to your body, which called eustress. And this eustress can stimulate your sympathetic nervous system. And in the long term, for the result, it will give the rebound, which give you the parasympathetic stimulation, will give you more relaxed and can increase your sleep quality as well. And last but not least, there are many studies that talk about like a microbiome, which is, I'm not talking about this right now. By consuming probiotic, because many people have like gut issues, just name it IBS, then like ulcerative colitis, gastritis, GERD, and etc. And I think by consuming probiotic, like in general, it will increase your gut microbiome health, that it's really related to your sleep quality as well. So I hope like to sum up like how to boost your metabolism and how to lose weight while you sleep can help you. If you guys have like any testimonial about like if you have done like some things that I mentioned before, you can comment on the section below, and maybe we can talk about like other beneficial things about sleep and etc. that related to hormone on the next video. See you. I hope you guys healthy and stay happy.